Another hour of love songs. This is BBC Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker and 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 10 o'clock. This is Catherine Cracknell. The frontrunner to become the next Prime Minister, Liz Truss, has promised she'll set out immediate action on energy bills next week if she's announced as leader of the Conservative Party tomorrow. She told the BBC's Laura Koonsberg she'd set out plans to cut taxes and get the economy growing again. And she also said she'd focus on securing long-term energy supplies for the UK.
If I'm elected as Prime Minister, I will act immediately on bills and on energy supply, because I think those two things go hand in hand. We need to deal with the immediate problem. Mm-hmm. We need to help people. We need to help businesses. But we also need to sort out the supply issues.
Ms Truss wouldn't be drawn on whether she'd also introduce direct support for pensioners and people on benefits. The Observer columnist Sonia Soda says she'll face some very difficult choices if she takes over.
Is she going to stick to this extremely expensive tax cut pledge that experts think, you know, will cost in the region of £50 billion a year, and will not give support to the poorest families, to people like pensioners, low-income parents? Or will she divert course and will she target support more closely to people who really need it the most?
The Home Secretary has said the Metropolitan Police must learn from what she called their appalling mistakes. Priti Patel's written to the force's new commissioner, Sir Mark Rowley, stressing the need for reform. Her intervention follows a string of failings, including the murder of Sarah Everard by a serving officer. Donald Trump's accused President Biden of weaponising the FBI against him following the raid to recover classified documents from his home. Mr. Biden had previously called Mr. Trump and his supporters an extremist threat to American democracy. NASA said it's unlikely to attempt another launch of its Artemis 1 moon mission for at least another few weeks. The second attempt at getting its largest ever rocket off the ground was thwarted yesterday after a fuel leak was discovered. Here's our science correspondent, Jonathan Amos.
It's been a deeply frustrating few days for NASA. The agency has had two goes at getting its powerful space launch system rocket off Earth, but technical shortcomings have made it impossible. Engineers have no alternative now but to begin a period of maintenance. The hydrogen leak that scuppered yesterday's countdown should be a fairly quick fix. But there are batteries on the rocket that require recertification, and that would ordinarily demand a lengthy trip back to the workshop.
Tennis, and at the US Open in New York, Britain's Cameron Norrie is through to the fourth round of the tournament after beating Holger Rune of Denmark in straight sets. Dan Evans lost to the Croatian Marin Cilic in four sets. And the weather, a dry and sunny day in southeast England. It'll be cloudier elsewhere with rain and heavy showers, rain clearing from Northern Ireland to become drier and brighter.